What is going on, ladies and gentlemen of YouTube? My name is Marksman. And today we have a Search and Destroy 20-0 Flawless here on Raid with the Vector, which is crazy. Give the video a like if you enjoy crazy gameplays, because that is what this is. A 20-0 is insane. It's in four rounds. I joined in late, one round down, and when I came back with the team 4-0. I should just say I came back. The team really didn't do a whole lot in this game. If I drop 20 of the 24, then that's pretty much all the work, isn't it? 5, 10, 15, 80%? 80% maybe? Ish? I don't know exactly the margin. But if you want to know how good a gameplay is, look at how many kills the person gets compared to how many they could possibly get. Because some people are like, I've had a 26-0 marksman. It's like, yeah, you played fucking all seven rounds, right? You got 26 of 42. Okay? 26-0 is great. But I usually die before I'm going to like go into another round. I usually try to get the defuse or, you know, do something. But anyways, let's get off that topic. Give the video a like if you enjoy crazy gameplays. Like I said, let's get into the topic I want to talk about in this video, which is kind of, I don't do regular commentaries as often nowadays, but I want to do them still. I have, when I come up with a good topic that I want to talk about, I do it. Rant videos included, which are fun. Almost killed myself there. Note to self, grenades take 5 seconds. Remember that. But I wanted to talk about how some people are like, hey, marksman, like, okay, I should give you more of a background story on this. So when I had, like, let's say when I went into surgery, I was like, oh man, I'm wiped. Or if I'm sick, I'm like, okay, I'm really tired, guys. I'm sick. I'm sorry. I can't really do as good of videos as I would like to. I still try to do as good as I can and put out content that's still enjoyable in every way possible. But it's hard for me to do commentaries that are long. It's hard for me to, continually talk and work to make good content because I got to play Call of Duty. Like, if you guys didn't know, videos take a lot of work. They do. Even these videos. I play for about 2 hours maybe a day, just recording. That's just recording. And then I'm going to stream later in the day for 4 to 5 hours. So that's 6 to 7 hours of Call of Duty in a day, no matter what, usually. Sometimes I skip the 2 hours and I just stream, but that's still 4 or 5 hours a day. And I stream almost every day. I rarely ever miss a day. Rarely. I'm telling you that. Like, if you stop by almost every day, 5:30 p.m. Central, I will be streaming. And if I have obligations like I did tonight, I was going to go play volleyball with a family member. I stream earlier in the day to make sure I still get my stream in and bring content to you guys. It's a lot of work. A lot of work goes into making videos. Some people think it's easy mode. It's not. Even for people that don't play Call of Duty, like Wildcat, for example, I was always like, oh man, it'd be easy to play non-Call of Duty games. I could just play for fun and mess around and we could have funny videos. He's going to play for like 3 or 4 hours at least. Then he has to go back and watch 3 or 4 hours. Take out all the footage he wants to use, and then he uses a bunch of crazy sound effects and things like that in his videos, which I don't really use sound effects as often in mine. I do some things I throw in here and there, but not as much. So videos are a lot of work. A lot of work goes into them, okay? Don't believe it's just like, you know, we screw around and just we have fun the whole time. It's work. It is. Anyways, let's go into what I wanted to talk about, where you can't take breaks on YouTube or streaming and things like that. You can't do it. Like, if you do, you become so irrelevant so quickly, it's unbelievable. And I could say some examples, but like I'll give you just my own example. On Twitch, I have, I think, 600,000 views-ish and 21,000 followers. And when I stream, I only will get about 300 to 400 concurrent viewers right now. And I should have more. I honestly should. I should probably have like 1,500. But since my followers are spread out over the course of 3 years, and why the fuck were 5 people in that little square, I don't know. But since my stream has been basically strewn along a 3-year path, I have followers that probably don't even watch streams anymore. I have followers from Skyrim. I have followers from Diablo 3. I have followers from Call of Duty MW3. I have followers from when I did Borderlands. I have followers from in all sorts of genres as well. So I never really stuck with streaming on a consistent basis, and I didn't do it in the same genre either, which makes it really hard to continue to grow. You can't really do that online. You can't take breaks at all. So when I'm sick and things like that, people are like, oh, take a break, Marksman, it's okay, we still love you, man. It's like, all right, I'm glad, I'm really happy that you will, but at the same time, I know from experience, and I know from watching a bunch of people do it, that in general, taking breaks on YouTube or streaming is like an instant way to kill your channel. And you can ask all the YouTubers this. Notice how a lot of YouTubers try to keep their content up like on a daily or weekly basis. They'll try to post at least a few videos, if not
multiple, like, 6 to 7 videos a week. Some people do even more. You have to stay consistent with online content. And that's a tip for you guys if you're going to get into it in general. Consistency is key. It's key and it's huge and it's really important if you guys would like to grow a channel. All right? It's one thing that I think a lot of people think is they underplay it. They underplay it, really. But you have to focus on that and stay strong with it and continue and be dedicated. But that's today's video. 20-0. Hope you guys enjoyed. Comment, rate, and subscribe if you'd like. If not, no worries. I will still love you. And as always, make sure to keep on gaming.